Through the Public Procurement and Disposal of Public Assets Authority, the government has issued a directive to ministries, agencies and departments to only procure grain from certified suppliers. Addressing journalists yesterday, State Minister for Investment and Privatization Evelyn Anite said that in a bid to ensure quality grains, Uganda National Bureau of Standards certified 630 service providers who will be the go-to for supply.
Uganda National Bureau of Standards has developed various standards for a range of grains and grain products. It has certified so far 630 service providers across the country for maize products, wheat products, production capacities for these 630 companies is estimated to be 217,000.
This means that entities like prisons, police, defense, and government-aided schools will only buy from these certified service providers. PPDA Executive Director Benson Churiamie said that the move is in line with PPDA Act Cap 205.
We are also saying there are those providers who have been having framework contracts, but we are saying update. We are going to tell entities that these providers must update their record under framework contract and show the certification. So if they are not satisfied and they have been supplying government, they will be removed from that framework contract.
The move comes at a time when the government seeks to solve aflatoxins in grain, especially maize. Last year, several trucks of Ugandan grain destined for South Sudan were ordered to return home after finding high levels of aflatoxins in them. In a significant development in the murder trial of businessman Henry Katanga, yesterday the prosecution presented its eighth witness, a DNA analyst. The expert testified to matching the deceased DNA with that of his accused widow and daughter. Andrew Kizimula Mubiru, the acting director for forensic services for the police, described the meticulous examination of numerous exhibits related to the case, including a black Zastava arms pistol recovered from the crime scene.
One projectile recovered from the bed of the deceased at the crime scene.
N'ekishoshongore kisasi ekyashangirwe omukishenge aho mugezi yaferire.
Ekindi akyenamba ekizikiti abimegiremwe.
22-1. It's described as blood swab.
N'eshagama.
From the door curtain.
Kuga omukatin z'omulyango.
To the balcony of the master bedroom.
Mubiru informed the court that DNA analysis was also conducted on swabs from the widow's right hand and a deceased left hand.
So the request was to examine all the above exhibits. For DNA traces. And ascertain whether the DNA traces.
State attorneys Jonathan Mwanganya and Anna Kiza, along with Assistant DPP Samali Waholi, said the case is heavily reliant on the forensic evidence provided by Mubiru. Court proceedings were then adjourned to today, when Mubiru will continue with his testimony. The Israeli military said it rescued an Israeli hostage in Gaza yesterday, more than 10 months after he was seized during the Hamas attacks that sparked a devastating war. Kaid Farhan Al-Kadi, a 52-year-old Israeli Bodin, was abducted by Palestinian militants during the October 7th Hamas attack on Israel, the military said in a statement. The military said that Al-Kadi was rescued in a complex operation in the southern Gaza Strip, adding that he was in stable condition and being transferred to a hospital for a medical checkup. Al-Kadi is from Rahat, a predominantly Arab town.
I'm
On October 7th, he had been working as a guard at a warehouse in southern Israel when he was seized by militants. Israeli campaign group The Hostages and Missing Families Forum described his rescue as miraculous. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu said Israel was working tirelessly to bring all our hostages back in a video issued shortly after he spoke with Al-Qadi.